Welcome to another Realvolve training video. This is Mark Stepp. I'm the CIO here at Realvolve and wanting to share a question that we get a lot about important dates. If you go to your transactions area and you look at your important dates, you'll see that there are dates that have been entered into the system, but whenever you go to the calendar side, the dates aren't showing in there. And there's a reason for doing that. Basically, whenever you're dealing with the transaction itself, you've got these different dates, and if you've got a team situation where you've got transaction coordinator, listing agent, buyer's agent, stuff like that, different team members may need these different dates on their calendar separately. So your transaction coordinator would want to be reminded on certain dates that are key to their job, where the listing agent would want to have certain key dates that are important to them. So what we have done is, instead of putting those dates in the calendar, we are assuming that you will take a workflow and add those dates to your calendar through the system based off of what your needs are. So if we go to the workflows area and we look for important transaction dates, I just did a search for important transaction dates. It brings up my important transaction date workflow, which I have created a sample of this in the workflow library. You can go under add workflow library, and there is a workflow named important transaction dates. You can install that. It only contains four of the important dates in there. You can add which ones are important to you. You'll see that in this particular one, I've gone ahead and modified this one similarly to the way that you would probably do it, where there are four dates for the agent, but maybe Annie, my assistant, would be interested in knowing certain dates of her own. And she could go in there, create the important dates, and assign those to her record just as easily as mine. If we go into a particular closing today, the assigned to is Joe Agent, and I go in under the schedule section, you'll see that we have created this as being 0 days after the closing date. Now you can pick any of the different important dates that are available. You can scroll through this list, pick whichever ones that you want to make sure are on your calendar and assign them. On certain milestone dates that we've got into the system, there are closing times, and you can assign the closing time to that as well. So whatever's in there. So what happens then is, whenever we use this particular activity in our workflow and we assign each of these activities to a particular transaction, it then adds it to our calendar. So I'm going to come over here to the radar, and I will click on start a workflow, and I want to click on important transaction dates, click on next. At this point, you'll see all the different activities are in there. Yes, there are some duplicates, but those are because those are to different users within our system. Click on next, and any of the dates that are filled in, great. If they're not filled in, it will fill them in later. Click on done. So at this point, if I go to my calendar for this particular transaction, you'll see that it shows all the different activities now in the calendar. Now, again, there are duplicates here because different users are looking at this one transaction, and having the ability to have that to each of their own calendars is important. But that's just it. You have the ability to create the activities on your calendar that are important to you. So I hope that makes sense. And one of the things that is happening here is, if you go in and, for instance, the closing date, if for some reason the closing date changes from the 31st to the 30th, I can just click on it, drag it, and boom, it's there. If I go then to my transactions section and look at my important dates, now the closing date has been changed from the 31st to the 30th for me. So it's all automatic. If I decide I come here and maybe, well, we're going to change it one more time to the 29th. At that point, because I've made that change and I go back to my calendar, click on the month, you'll now see that the closing date has changed to the 29th. So it adjusts once it's on the calendar. It adjusts as it needs, but it doesn't put it onto your calendar until the workflow adds it. If you have additional questions, visit our website, send us an email, or visit our online support, and we'd be happy to answer those questions. Have a great day.